there's the Miskar. Hello to everybody over there.
Okay.
Miss Scarlet says hello.
She's panting because we've been running around outside. Or she has been, anyway. Oops, forgot to change the chalkboard. Alright guys, we are watching Queen from their Live Aid performance today from 1985. Roger says hey, by the way. So, this video comes to us from a Patreon request from Paul Maxey. He requested Queen at Live Aid, which is a 20-minute set that features 6 songs. 7 if you include the song where Freddie and Brian come back, sing an extra song. I think you will enjoy it. So, here's the thing. I have seen this before. It's been a while, though, since I've seen it. And when I watched it, I was not really very acquainted with Queen. I didn't even know some of the songs that they sing in here were some of their songs, because I grew up hearing them my entire life, but had no idea who actually sang them. And honestly, I still don't know much about Queen. I know Freddie Mercury. I do know Queen is British, and I think their most famous song is probably Bohemian Rhapsody, which I have seen the music video for. I had only heard like tiny snippets of that song. I heard of Live Aid before, did not know what in the world it was actually for. For some reason, I thought it was about the AIDS epidemic in Africa, but it turns out that's not the case, so I did kind of get some background information on this. So I did find out that this was in regard to the Ethiopian famine that was happening between 1983 to 85. And why did I say fame right there? With an E on it, oh my gosh. And there were 2 concerts going on simultaneously. We had one in London, which took place at Wembley Stadium, and we had the other one simultaneously in Philadelphia at the JFK Stadium. They raised £150 million. Pounds, that's equal to 183 million in US dollars, which I guess for back then, that was, you know, way more than it would be today. And I was curious about like some of the acts that were performing in London versus the US. Both had like really, really good performers. I think some of the larger ones in the UK were, well, first of all, I noticed that the Coldstream Guards performed, and I like to see that just because that's a military band, right? I think some of the bigger bands were like Sting, U2, of course Queen, The Who, Elton John, you know, Paul McCartney. And then over in the US, they had like some of the bigger ones I can think of, the Four Tops, Black Sabbath, Beach Boys, you know, Santana, Madonna, Eric Clapton. There are so many other like big names. I'm not gonna take all the time to write them here, but I did notice that Phil Collins somehow performed in both the UK and the US, and I'm not sure how that happened. Were they actually like simulcasting it? Like you could watch both at the same time? Because if so, like how did Phil Collins perform in both places? Did he literally like fly between the two continents and do that? Or was it like a satellite feed? Or I don't know. So apparently, you know, this is a 20-minute show. Queen is kind of known for stealing the show here. I didn't get that sense when I first watched it. Maybe I will watching it this time. But I guess you would really have to like see it in context of maybe the other acts and stuff to really understand that. But I do think Queen's a really, really unique band. Before I realized who they were, I didn't know they were British. I thought that it was a woman. I literally thought Queen was just like a female singer or something. I didn't know that Queen was a like a rock band, basically. So, well, let's go ahead and let's watch this. Should be fun. Hopefully there aren't going to be any copyright issues. I have no idea. Since it's been uploaded to YouTube so many times, I'm assuming they'll let me put it up. It'll probably be copyrighted, I'm sure, though.
Hello, over here in England, can I just have a bit of help and attention from the guys down the front? You're all getting very hot and bothered. I just want everybody in the back.
The just been updated, hasn't it, the stadium? Look at how many people are. Is that people in the back?
Nobody's
like
got
in the street? Or so are those houses?
This is a lead vocal.
This is a bit of space. We'll be on in about 1 minute.
I like the anticipation when you go to a concert and you're just sitting there listening to it, like, warm up and get ready and stuff. Feed the world. Oh yeah, also like the USA for the We Are the World song came out of this too, which I...
Ladies and gentlemen, could we have a very warm Wembley welcome, please, for Mel Smith and Griff Rhys-Jones.
What is this?
Here. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2.
Is this like a comedy duo?
Yeah, I know what follows two. Constable, thank you very much.
This is our spare lead vocal, Mike.
Constable.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but we have had a bit of a complaint about the noise. From a woman in Belgium. So, if you could just keep it
vocal.
Ladies and gentlemen, obviously, boys and girls, we're enjoying the boogie-woogie music here today. But I would ask you to bear in mind that there are a lot of people, perhaps older people, in the area, who perhaps aren't up to date with the latest trends in modern music. Like Status Quo, for example.
I'm not up to date either, because I don't know what Status Quo is.
To introduce the next combo, who are Her Majesty Queen.
Two.
Queen works.
Griff Rhys-Jones and Mel Smith on stage at Wembley. Now, here are Queen.
People that are behind that tent in the middle of the stadium. Talking about like killing somebody and maybe he'll kill himself. I don't know, but what's... Is there a meaning behind it? Weird mic stand. He is a showman, I have to say. He is a showman. Kind of reminds me of Elvis in that way a little bit. Obviously very different moves. But still that same aura, you know.
And what you're like, my only friend, through teenage nights.
Never been a man to know.
I heard it on my radio. You were never those old time stars. You was the worst. It made my loss. You made them laugh. You made them cry. You made us.
Watching the audience. I think I've heard this part of it. This part is kind of catchy, you know? Like this, like the 80s synth. Like choreography apparently. Okay. Got the Elvis poses a little bit. I like the Queen look in the 80s better than their 70s look that I saw in the Rhapsody video. Pretty powerful being able to control a crowd like that.
diddle, diddle. All right.
He's got such like hammer fall. He's got very unique moves. Sounds like a song I might have heard before, but I don't know. Every night, every day, a little piece of you is falling away. Lift your eyes, the wish you made it. Tell your line and play the game. To the end of that it covers it all. Till one day they call your name. I don't think I noticed. Okay, maybe see why they say this was a show stealer, just because of Freddie Mercury's performance. I mean, it's good music too. I might have heard like the melody or and the guitar riffs are kind of familiar to me in that. I feel like I've heard them before. I mean, obviously I've watched this before, but I mean, other than that, I think I've heard them before. But I'm not familiar with the song. But it sounded like he was talking about like war. Oh, he does play guitar. I obviously don't remember very much from the first time I watched this.
This next song is only dedicated to beautiful people here tonight. It means all of you. Thank you for coming along and making this a great occasion.
Is this an Elvis song? Maybe that's why I know it. Sounds like something Elvis would sing. He's singing it kind of like Elvis. I think he's impersonating Elvis there. Sounds like it anyway. That punch you. Was that an Elvis song, or did he write that to make it kind of sound like an Elvis song? This is the We Will Rock You, right? So this song I heard my entire life growing up because they play it at like sports events and stuff. I had no idea who sang it and was absolutely floored the first time I watched this and I realized it was Queen that sang it. I would have never guessed in a million years.
Yeah!
the stamp, and then... It's gotta be one of the most iconic rock and roll songs that I always associate with sports and not rock and roll. Oh, that was short. He's really talented, you know, piano, guitar, and fabulous voice too. Time after time. In my sentence, but committed no crime, and bad mistakes I've made a few. I know this song too. This is just like We Will Rock You. I had no idea they sang this song, that they were the ones that did it. I've grew up my entire life, again, I associate it with sports stuff, you know. It's a perfect song for like sports champions. Had no clue. We Will Rock You and We Are the Champions, two of the most iconic songs that probably everywhere in the world, or at least in the Western world, I don't know, we use these songs, you know, in sports. You know, it's crazy how many times you hear songs and you don't know who sings them. Did this too. There you go. It's so weird with that many people doing it though. Wonder if his voice was getting tired of those high notes. He went down on that. My bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune, everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But it's been a bed of roses. No pleasure to me. Wonder if they clean those mics after each show. Amplifiers are on the stage. What? We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers. We are the champions. We are the champions, my friend. And we'll keep on fighting. He's having a hard time singing those high notes, which I don't blame him. I could not find one that had like the encore where they came back out. I don't know if that's missing in this. If it is, I apologize, but I couldn't find the one that had that. They all kind of ended at this point. So watching it this time, I think I do understand why it was considered the show stealer for this. Now, I haven't watched any of the other part of Live Aid. I've not watched anything else from it, so I don't have anything to compare it to. Just the energy from Freddie Mercury, the passion that he put into it, and just like all of the unique like dance moves that he did, the way he like dances with the microphone stand, and like who does that, you know? He does. So I can understand like how that would stick out compared to maybe just your more run-of-the-mill act. I don't know what all his amps were doing on stage. Is that what they used to pump the sound out into the audience? I mean, I saw other speakers as well, but I know that back in the day with the Beatles, like back in the 60s, they had to use like the amps on stage to get the sound out to even huge stadiums, which seems nuts to me, but I don't know like when that changed. I also was kind of like just like watching what a concert was like back then, just like noticing the lack of screens and lights, special effects, all of that stuff, which you don't really need that for a concert like this. I mean, Freddie Mercury was enough to keep you entertained the whole time. The music was good, it kept you engaged the whole time. Even the songs that I didn't know were fun to listen to. And I didn't see any screens. I don't know if they had them or not, because there were a lot of cameras there, and I know that they were broadcasting it around the world, I think via satellite, and it was like a huge satellite broadcast. But I didn't see any screens like around the stage at all, and so I feel really, really sorry for the people that were like behind the, I think it was maybe a little camera pavilion in the middle of it, and there was another one at the back of the stadium, and I don't know what that was for, but the poor people that were behind that. they probably couldn't see anything. They could just enjoy the sound of the music, I guess. So that was a lot of fun to go back and watch. I don't know, like I might have to get into Queen a little bit. I did enjoy the music. They're not the sort of band that I would be automatically drawn to. I really like the more poppy, like Beach Boys. Beach Boys are my favorite band. They did a lot of good music. You know, Freddie Mercury is really talented. I don't know about, I mean, the whole band is talented, but I don't know any of the other people in Queen. I just know Freddie Mercury. And I know people always laud him for his vocal abilities. He is very good. He is very good. I wouldn't say there are a lot of really good singers out there that I think are on his level, but he definitely has a very smooth classic rock tight sound to him. The fact that he plays piano, I've heard other people comment that he really studied music and studied piano, and he was like classically trained or something. Or maybe I just read that somewhere else, but I can understand like his voice sounds like he would be like classically trained. Maybe that's where that smoothness comes from, and he's so good at jumping around the notes without doing the slur up and down, you know, as a lot of singers do. He just kind of like jumps right to it. Yeah, he very, very, very talented with that. Plays guitar, piano as well, which a lot of musicians do, but it was interesting that he didn't use a pick playing the electric guitar. He just kind of strummed it with his fingers. Yeah, but this is literally this and the Bohemian Rhapsody video that I've seen is the extent of my Queen experience. The one that sounded like the Elvis song, the crazy little thing called Love, feel like, I don't know, like maybe that was a Queen original that he just kind of like wrote to sound like 50-ish, like an Elvis type song, or maybe Elvis really sang it. If it's true that he is just doing a cover of an Elvis song, he looked like he was kind of doing some, or attempting to do some Elvis moves too with the guitar and while he was singing, of course mimicking the voice a little bit. It makes me wonder if he was an Elvis fan, you know, if he really studied Elvis, because if so, that might be where some of his showmanship comes from. He might have gotten that from Elvis, because Elvis, I think, was the first person really in music to do stuff like that. So he may have just like taken that and kind of, you know, put his own style into it. He's definitely a lot more energetic than Elvis. Elvis was a bit more, he did a lot of like flashy moves and stuff, but he wasn't all over the stage quite as much as Freddie Mercury was. I mean, he was just on every inch of that stage. And the stamina that he had to have to do that, sweat pouring down, he was out of breath. So yeah, thanks Paul for the suggestion on, or the request on Patreon. And it's been a nice, fun little, kind of different video. a storm outside, you guys. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe if you haven't done that yet. And also check out my social media. I got all this stuff on social media, email, PO box. All of the links are in the description and the pinned comment. And I also have a Patreon with all of this stuff on there. So if you are a fan of any of these shows, and we got a lot of movies that I've done, like live movie nights, chats, all of that stuff is over on Patreon. I don't put that stuff up here on YouTube. So there's a lot of other videos over there. A little bit different type of content. The link is in the description and the pinned comment if you want to go check that out. It's thundering outside. Scarlett's starting to get a little... She's starting to get scared. So I think I'm gonna go tend to her now. Yeah, thanks guys for watching this. Roger and I thank you guys. Scarlett's freaking out, guys.
Scarlett, he's okay.
She panics, guys, when thunder starts, so.
He's okay.
Aw. All right, well, I'm gonna go. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.
He's okay.